We're going to take a look at exponential growth and decay. So we're going to make, and don't forget to keep going to the table of contents. So we're going to make a title page, just exponentials, cut all the way down to the margin. And then from there, you're going to make tabs. So my first tab is going to be growth slash decay. And take your ruler, cut across to the margin, and then all the way down. And then, of course, you're going to pause the video and copy all the notes down. Alright, so this formula is going to be given to you in the formula sheet. You just need to know what everything means. So y equals a b raised to the x power. You just need to know what everything is. So y is the population or the amount after a certain time. A is the beginning amount. B is the rate of growth or decay, and it needs to be a decimal. Very important. So if it's growth, it's 1 plus r. If it's decay, it's 1 minus r. And x is the time. Okay, you also need to know that b is a multiplier. What y is multiplied by each time, and x grows up by 1 when you look at a table. All right, so let's take a question. All right, and you need to pull out information. So the very first step is going to be to write the formula. So go ahead and write the formula down. Y equals a b raised to x. The second step is going to be fill in the numbers, fill in all the information they give you in the question. So use a pen, a highlighter, and underline what you need to. The original value, original, meaning the beginning, is 1400. That's going to be your A, because that's your starting amount. So you put in 1400 where A is. And the value increases by 9% each year. Rate of growth or decay is B. Okay, but it needs to be as a decimal. So my third step is going to turn the percent into a decimal by dividing by 100. That's going to give you R. So you turn percent into a decimal divided by 100. So I take 9% divided by 100. That's going to give me a decimal of 0.09. That's going to be R. Because this is growth, because it increases, it's going to be 1 plus R to get B. If it's decreasing, it's going to be 1 minus R. If it's increasing, so it's going to be 1 plus R. So 1 plus 0.09 is going to give me my B value of 1.09. So you're going to plug that in. So B is in the parentheses, you plug that in. Step 4, growth, you add 1. Decay, you subtract from 1. This is a listening check color. In step 3, 10% to a decimal. All right, and the final thing is X, the time period. What is the time period? It says it's 25 years, so you put that in. So they're asking what is the amount after all that. So the final step is just going to be to punch that in the calculator. So step 5, punch and calculate. So you're going to take the calculator and you're going to type it as it is. 1400 parentheses 1.09. And then that button right there means raised. It's like a little triangle without the bottom. And then that's where you put the time 25. Because this is money, right, we need two numbers after the decimal because that's how you write cents. So what's a 2 going to do? Nothing. So it leaves it just as 12,072 and 31 cents. We're going to do it again. First thing is definitely write down the formula. And I'm just highlighting all the things. I can see it's increasing. So again, this is growth. So just look for that keyword, increasing or decreasing. Okay, so I just highlighted all the numbers. So I'm writing down the formula. And I'm just going to fill in the information. So it's increasing at a rate of 8%. So that's my R. But that's in percent, and I have to write it down as what? A decimal. So I'm going to divide that by 100. Then to find my B, because it's growth, I'm going to add 1 to that number. So that's going to give me my B of 1.08. What else do I have? Its value in 2000 was 1200. And this is going to be a listening check. I'm going to write different numbers, but you write what I'm saying. Okay, so your starting population was 1,200. And then it went from the year 2000 to 2006. How many years is that? It's 6. So this is a listening check. Don't put 4, put 6. Then you're going to punch it into the calculator. Again, I'm going to punch in the wrong number. This is a listening check. Punch in what I'm saying. So 1,200 parentheses 1.08 close parentheses raised to the power of 6, not 4. That's going to give you 1904.249188, round into the nearest hundredth, because again, it's money. The 9 is going to make the 4 go up by 1, giving you $1,904.25. And don't forget to put the dollar because it is wrong. So again, if you wrote any of that, you just missed all the listening checks. For the listening check, put a box around Y equals 1904.25. All right, so again, remember growth, and I'm going to change that to B equals, is 1+% as a decimal. Very, very important. So growth is 1+% as a decimal. That's going to give you B. Decay, on the other hand, is 1-% as a decimal. 1-% of the decimal, but it's the same exact thing. So again, step one is going to be write down the formula. So let's go ahead and do that. Again, this formula is given to you in the formula sheet, so you don't have to memorize it. Step two is fill in the numbers. So what do they give me? So look through the question. The population is decreasing. Decreasing means going down. That's how you know it's decay. 1%. So again, to find R as a decimal, you're going to divide it by 100. So 1 divided by 100. So again, step 3 is to turn it into a decimal by dividing by 100. So I'm just going to do it over here on the side. 1 divided by 100, and it's going to be 1-% as a decimal. So 1-1/100. And just punch that whole thing in the calculator, just like you see. Just remember, anytime you have a fraction, you always put it in parentheses. So you can do 1-(1/100). It'll give you the same answer as you do it individually. So now you're just going to plug in the numbers that you know. So that's what B is, so that's 0.99. A is what I start with. In 2000, there were 1,300 people. So I started with 1,300 people in the year 2000. So that's where A goes, 1,300 people. Then what's my time? Well, it's saying from the year 2000 to 2008. How many years is that? That's 8. And then final step. I forgot to write the notes. So calculate B by 1-% as a decimal. Then step 5, use the calculator. Punch it in exactly as you see it. So again, 1300, open parentheses, 0.99, close parentheses. And then using the triangle thingy looking thing that's not, doesn't have a bottom. And then 8. When it comes to rounding, you have to use your common sense. You have to know what they're talking about. We were talking money in my previous questions, but now we're talking people. You can't have a point something of a person, so you need to round this one to the nearest whole number. So that 5 is going to make that go up by 1, which is going to make that go up by 1, which is going to make the 1 go up by 1. So it's 1200. Make sure you put in the units as well. So let's take a look at one more example again. Write down the formula. This is a listening check. Color in the formula you just wrote down. Find the numbers. So it's decreasing, which means decay, at a rate of 3%. So it's 1-% as a decimal. So it's going to be 1-, and how do you turn percent into a decimal? You divide by 100, so 1-3/100. And you just punch that into the calculator to get 0.97, just as it is. Just remember to put parentheses around any fractions anytime you do it. So B is that. Right, starting amount, the original population is going to be A, which is 48,000. And then after 7 years, so the time is 7, and punch that into the calculator. So again, we're talking about people. Because we're talking about people, you can have point something of a person. So you're going to round this to the nearest whole number. So what's the 1 going to do? Nothing. So this is going to be 38,783 people. Hopefully that's right. That's pretty much it. So let's practice.